Are you struggling with building muscle and gaining weight? Well, this video is just for you. Hey guys, welcome back to the Fitness Freak. In this video, we'll be looking at the science of gaining weight. A lot of people have this problem of gaining weight. In fact, that's the second most common problem that we have in the fitness world right after losing weight. So half the people seem to have trouble with losing weight and the remaining half have a problem with gaining weight. Now, the people who don't know how to lose weight, go watch this video. I've already made a detailed video on how to lose weight within just 60 days, and that's worked miracles for a number of people, and I'm sure it's going to help you out as well. For those of you who are unable to put on weight, this video is going to explain the best ways to gain that weight without much of fat. I perfectly understand where you're coming from because I was in your place once. As most of my subscribers may be aware by now, I had a massive weight loss transformation from 120 kilos to 55 kilos. If you're new to this channel and if you haven't seen that transformation, it'll be up here somewhere. So just click on it, watch that first, and then come back to see this video so that you would know where I'm coming from and you would know whether the information that I'm giving is reliable. Right after my transformation, I was stuck in a 55 kilo frame and I was unable to gain weight. And I could have gained all that weight back by eating whatever I wanted. I could have practically had burgers and pizzas all day, all night, and I could have gained the weight back. But I didn't want to gain it as fat. No. I wanted to gain as good quality weight. I wanted to gain a decent amount of muscle mass. And muscle is hard to build if you don't know what to eat. And if you are on a budget, then you better be very particular about the foods that you are going to incorporate into your diet to help you build that mass. So I spoke to a dozen plus natural bodybuilders and did some research of my own in order to come to a clear conclusion. Just like a calorie deficit helps with weight loss, weight gain is the straight opposite. You need to be on a caloric surplus. Most of you might ask now, that's easy for you to say, but how much calories to eat? What sort of calories should I consume? And what are the foods to eat? And how much of it to eat? So many questions, right? Let's take it down one by one. First, we need to know how much of calories you need to eat. And to do this, you need to quickly calculate your basal metabolic rate. Now, basal metabolic rate is the amount of calories your body would burn if you just sit idle on your chair for a whole day straight. So here's a quick formula to calculate the basal metabolic rate. Pause the screen, take it down, calculate your basal metabolic rate. And once you're done, resume the video. Ready with the BMR? Let's continue. Now, your BMR times each of these activity level multiplier is going to represent your total daily energy expenditure, meaning the amount of energy your body burns and requires in return from the foods that you're consuming to maintain your body weight. Now, these activity level multipliers are based on the amount of hours you are doing external activities. First one is for a sedentary lifestyle. If you are typically waking up in the morning, going to work, coming back home, then the sedentary lifestyle applies to you. If you go once or twice out during the week, play some cricket, play some football, and then come back home, and then do your working and all these things, then you are falling into category number two, that is lightly active, and so forth and so on. So based on the number of hours you are active during the week, choose your activity level and multiply that against your BMR to get your accurate TDEE. Now, once you get your total daily energy expenditure, the science over here is pretty simple. Most of the people who are underweight or who are struggling to gain weight are not even consuming their exact total daily energy expenditure. If you're doubting this, go use a calorie counting application and count the number of calories you're consuming in your tomorrow's meals. You'd be surprised because the average total daily energy expenditure would be around 2,500 and most of us would be stuck consuming around 2,200. So most of us aren't even consuming our exact calorie intake that's required to maintain our body mass. We are consuming under our calories. But to bulk up, to actually put on weight, you need to be consuming a surplus of this total daily energy expenditure. Let's take my case for example. My BMR is around 1600 calories and I am a moderately active person. I exercise about 5 to 6 hours a week. So I would fall into this moderate activity level. So my TDEE will be 1600 times 1.55 and that would come around 2480. So let's keep it as 2500 for simplicity. I need to consume 500 calories on top of 2500 calories in order to bulk up, in order to gain weight. How much weight, you ask? Research proves that if you consume 500 calories in excess of your TDEE for at least a week straight, you will gain half a kilo. That's good, given that it's all coming from healthy fats and a healthy diet. And it's, none of it is junk. It's going to result in healthy weight gain. And you know what's the best thing with a healthy weight gain? It's not going to go away that easily when you stop dieting. I have personally experienced whenever I bulk up for a period of 6 months and then begin my cutting phase. Whenever I'm bulking up, the weight pretty much stays at least a month after the bulking phase. So the weight that you're going to gain, the rate of 0.5 kilo per week, is going to result in like a weight gain of 2 kilos a month. All you need to do this is count the calories in your food. And I'm going to give you a list of calorie dense foods. And if you follow to consume these foods and keep counting your calories, I guarantee you that your weight will increase by at least 2 kilos by the completion of 1 month from the start of this diet. So without further ado, let's have a look at the diet.
As before I show you the dietary information, do remember that you require a weighing scale to get started with the diet, because everything is in measurements of grams, and you require a weighing scale to maintain accuracy. First off, we'll be taking carbohydrates into account with their calorie count on the right, and all of this is in 100 grams equivalent. So we have wheat pasta, oats, multigrain toast bread and chapatis. Next off, we got proteins, which are also in 100 grams equivalent for the respective calories. And for the non-veg eaters over here, we got chicken breast, mutton and boiled eggs. And for the vegetarians, we got paneer and chickpeas. And here's a list of vegetables for the vegetarians that can be incorporated to construct their bulking diets. These are also in 100 grams equivalent for the respective calories on the right. The final component you require is fats. Now, fats come in the form of nuts and oils. Here we are looking at nuts in 100 grams equivalent and their respective calories on the right. And here you'll be looking at all the oils, which are in tablespoon equivalents, with their calories on the right. So you can use all of these to construct your bulking diet accordingly. And for those of you who are still confused with how these ingredients can be used to build your diet, let me show you a quick day in my life and how I use the same ingredients to build my bulking diet. Now, first off, for breakfast, I'd have 4 boiled eggs, some oats and milk. Now, these together total up to 1219 calories. Then for lunch, I'd have some white rice along with some lentil and some chicken breast. And these together total up to 1258 calories. And then finally for dinner, I'd have some chapati and some potato in the form of sabzi. And this together comes to 530 calories. Put all these together and my total daily caloric intake is around 3000, which as per my TDE and activity level multiplier helps me to bulk up from 75 kilos to 85 kilos within a period of 5 months.
So that's it for the diet, guys. I hope you found this information helpful. The reason I'm making these videos is to spread awareness on fitness and nutrition so that it helps a lot of you people to reach your physical goals, whether it is losing weight or gaining weight and building muscle at the same time. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button and share this video with whomever you feel who needs to hear this information and who needs to gain weight, so that it helps more people with reaching their goals. If you want to support me, subscribe to my channel and turn on the bell icon so that you'll receive notifications on my future video updates. And if you have any questions with regards to this diet or any other diets that I have mentioned in my channel before, do leave it down in the comment section below. Also, if you want me to cover any other topic with relation to fitness, lifestyle or nutrition, do mention that also in the comment section below so that can give me an idea of what next to make video on. So I'll catch you in another video, guys. Until then, keep it fit.